In the spring of 1948, a tornado struck just southeast of Oklahoma City. Its path of destruction included Tinker Air Force Base. The weather forecasts for that day included severe thunderstorms, but there were no warnings of tornadoes issued by either the Air Force or the National Weather Service. The destruction caused by the storm was extensive. Just 5 days later, on March the 25th, 1948, U.S. Air Force meteorologists studying the conditions which possessed striking similarities to those of the earlier tornado issued the first tornado forecast in history. Their forecast proved to be correct when another tornado struck the base that day. The Air Force then commissioned a study, conducted by Major Ernst Vorbusch and Captain Robert C. Miller, both meteorologists. They published the results of their work in an official USAF report in 1952 under the title Tornado Alley. By the mid-1950s, the term had begun to be applied with increasing frequency in the media when referring to tornadoes and severe weather across several American states. Though it has never been an official designation adopted by any U.S. government agency, it is a part of the American lexicon. So what is it? Where is it? Why is the area it encompasses more susceptible to the deadly storms than other regions of the United States or the rest of the world? Tornado Alley has no official boundaries. Depending on the perspective of the observer, it can stretch from Texas to South Dakota, from Colorado eastward into western Ohio. Some reporters limit it to a much narrower corridor. Arguably, the most famous tornado of all time, the fictional storm which picked up Dorothy, Toto, and their Kansas farmhouse, depositing it on top of the Wicked Witch of the East in Munchkinland, occurred in Kansas. To many, the heart of Tornado Alley. Yet Texas, not Kansas, annually leads the U.S. in the number of tornado strikes, at least for the last several decades. There is scientific data which suggests that Tornado Alley is gradually shifting eastward, and there are other sections of the country where the incidence of tornado strikes has led to similar designations, such as Dixie Alley across Mississippi, Alabama, and the Southeast. Yet the Southern Central Plains retain the designation of Tornado Alley, and each year brings unfortunate reminders of the area's tendency to produce the sudden destruction which a tornado or series of tornadoes can unleash. And here's why. A tornado, sometimes referred to as a whirlwind, twister, or erroneously as a cyclone, is a column of air rotating with great speed while in contact with an airborne cumulonimbus cloud and the ground. Although they occur in nations across the world, the United States has the dubious distinction of leading the globe in tornadoes annually by a wide margin. Canada, especially its central plains, is second on the list. In the most violent and deadly form, tornadoes can reach wind speeds over 300 miles per hour and cover more than 60 miles on their wandering path. The circumference, the inner portion of the column, can be several miles. Fortunately, most are considerably smaller than those extremes, with wind speeds of just over 100 miles per hour, traveling just a handful of miles. Few tornadoes live longer than 5 to 10 minutes. Their visibility comes from condensed water within the funnel, enhanced by dust and debris which the winds kick up. They can adopt a shape of a long, undulating funnel, called a rope tornado, Dorothy's fictional storm with such a shape, or they can appear as wide as they are tall, called a wedge or stone pipe tornado. Some are not visible at all, other than by the swirl of debris at their base. In the Northern Hemisphere, all tornadoes rotate in a counterclockwise direction. This makes them travel in easterly or northeasterly direction over land. Despite the differences in appearance, shape, and size, they all form in the same manner. Tornadoes form when cooler air, descending in a downdraft, collides with warmer air arising from the ground, both of which rotate with increasing speed, depending on the strength of the storm. Such conditions arise within thunderstorms, though not all thunderstorms, thankfully, spawn tornadoes. The difference in temperature between the falling cool air and the rising warm air is a factor in increasing the spin of the vortex, and thus the strength of the ensuing tornado. The tornado moves across the ground, driven by prevailing winds as well as its own rotation, in a manner similar to a spinning top wandering as it rotates. Tornadoes are measured and ranked using a system that relies on the destruction and damage that they caused. The system was developed by Dr. Ted Fujita, a meteorologist working at the University of Chicago. Dr. Fujita's system, called the Fujita Scale, gave researchers an advantage when studying the history of tornado activity. Since it relies on assessments of damage caused by the storm to gauge the tornado's strength, storms dating back to the 1880s could be assessed and rated. The calculations have been modified based on experience and practice, and the scale is now referred to as the Enhanced Fujita Scale. Scale, the EF scale. Tornadoes are ranked from F0 to F5 using the scale. An F0 storm describes estimated wind speeds of 47 to 72 miles per hour. Just over 44% of all tornadoes fall into this category and result in little to light damage. F1 storms are those in which the wind speed reaches 112 miles per hour, causing moderate damage, which includes the stripping of roofs, overturned mobile homes and sheds, and trees snapped off at the trunk. Damage increases correspondingly with F2 through F4 storms, which together account for about 20% of all tornadoes. Damage from F4 storms is understandably described as devastating, since an F4 storm packs winds up to 260 miles per hour. F5 storms occur less than 0.1% of the time, though evidence indicates that their occurrence has increased over the past few decades. Up to 320 mile per hour winds can topple brick buildings, damage skyscrapers, and crush automobiles, or toss them for miles. F5 storms are lethal, but so are F3, which have been known to lift forklifts and deposit them yards away from their standing spot. Any storm from F3 up can cause almost unbelievable damage in a matter of just a few minutes. In 2007, the United States adopted the Enhanced Fujita Scale, the EF scale, followed by Canada in 2013. Both nations' weather authorities believed the EF scale to be more accurate and issued guidelines which define anything over F2 to be intense. However, predicting the intensity of a tornado in advance of its destructive appearance has remained somewhat hit or miss, no pun intended. When data and computer modeling indicate conditions are such that EF2 and up storms are possible, America's National Weather Service issues a special tornado watch called a particularly dangerous situation, a PDS watch. The region typically referred to as Tornado Alley reaches from Louisiana and north-central Texas across Oklahoma and most of Kansas and Nebraska and into South Dakota. Portions of Colorado, New Mexico, and Iowa are often included. Some researchers extend Tornado Alley to the east, including sections of Illinois, Indiana, and western Ohio. Others include Minnesota, Wisconsin, and Missouri. All of these states share in common the fact that they are west of the Allegheny Mountain ranges and east of the Rockies. Tornadoes can and have occurred in every state, but they are more likely in those states located in the central areas of the nation. Tornado Alley, as it most commonly is defined, is bordered by the Gulf of Mexico to the southeast, the arid deserts of New Mexico and Arizona to the southwest, and the relatively cool climate of the northwest along the edges of Nebraska and South Dakota. It is the region where warm, moist air from the Gulf meets cool, moist air from the northwest, as well as the warm, dry air from the southwestern desert. This creates conditions, particularly in the spring, which are ideal for the formation of thunderstorms and tornadoes. In the spring, the temperature variations tend to be more extreme. Texas leads the United States in the number of reported tornadoes per year, but Texas is a large state. To put things in perspective, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, released a study conducted between 1991 and 2010. In the study, NOAA ranked the states by number of tornadoes per 10,000 square miles of land area per year. Texas did not rank in the top 10, instead coming in at number 17. Of the states considered to be in the traditional definition of Tornado Alley, only Kansas, 2, ranked in the top 5. Kansas logged 11.7 tornadoes per 10,000 miles per year, nearly double that of Texas and its 5.9. Leading the list was Florida with 12.3. The top 10 also included Mississippi, Louisiana, Alabama, and South Carolina. Less well known than Tornado Alley, Dixie Alley is a term that originated with Alan Pearson, the director of the National Severe Storms Forecast Center, NSSFC, in 1971. The states that comprise Dixie Alley include Arkansas, Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee, and Kentucky. Some scientists include both Carolinas in the definition. Unlike Tornado Alley, the land in Dixie Alley is frequently hilly, even mountainous. Some sections are heavily wooded. In Dixie Alley, tornadoes often form late at night or early in the morning, while in Tornado Alley, late afternoon or early evening is a more likely time for tornado activity. The area described as Dixie Alley has a long history of devastating storms, including the series of storms known as the 2011 Super Outbreak, the largest on record in the United States. Over a period of 4 days, April the 25th through the 28th, over 175 tornadoes struck in Alabama, Tennessee, and Mississippi. States outside of Dixie Alley were struck as well, including Virginia and even New York. On April the 27th, 4 of more than 216 tornadoes reported that day were assessed as EF5. One such storm passed through Alabama and Tennessee, destroying 5 Alabama towns and killing over 70 people. Only one other time in recorded history has had more than 2 EF5 tornadoes appear in the United States on the same day, and that would be April the 3rd, 1974. There were multiple EF4 tornadoes during the outbreak as well, most of them in Dixie Alley. A mile-wide EF4 wedge tornado cut a 14-mile-long path of cleared timber in the Great Smoky Mountains National Park. April the 27th, 2011 saw no fewer than than 34 tornadoes classified as EF3 and up. They caused 316 fatalities, over 3,100 non-fatal fatalities, and untold property damage. In some sections of Mississippi, the storms were strong enough to strip the pavement from roads and sweep away the soil beneath, creating a massive trench. Those who extend Tornado Alley into Illinois, Indiana, and Ohio often cite the 1974 super outbreak to support their position. The 1974 outbreak did not include as many separate tornadoes as in 2011, but it nonetheless was the most violent 24-hour tornado outbreak in history. Not less than 30 EF4 or EF5 tornadoes struck, all of them east of the Mississippi River. During the 24-hour period, April the 3rd and 4th, 15 tornadoes were on the ground at the same time, and 148 separate storms did damage across 13 states to an extent which exceeded $7.5 billion as measured in today's dollars. Alabama reported 77 tornadoes, Kentucky 71, Indiana 47, Tennessee 45, and Ohio 38. No less than 5 EF5 tornadoes occurred during the super outbreak. One of them occurred in Xenia, Ohio, LH1, a small town east of Dayton. In Xenia, railway freight cars were lifted from a moving freight train as it passed through the center of town. Whole buildings, some of brick and stone construction, were blown away, leaving behind the slabs that they'd been built on. When President Richard Nixon visited the remains of Xenia a few days later, he called to mind the devastation he had personally witnessed following other natural disasters, including Hurricane Camille in 1969, to quote, "In terms of destruction, just total devastation, this is the worst I have ever seen." About an hour after the destruction in Xenia, another tornado of EF3 strength formed in southeast Indiana, crossed the Ohio River, and grew to EF4 strength as it moved northeast. It crossed the Ohio again at Cincinnati, grew to EF5 strength as it smashed several neighborhoods of the city, and finally dissipated northwest of the city. Meanwhile, the same thunderstorm that spawned it launched another tornado of EF4 strength near Elmwood Place, another Cincinnati neighborhood. It eventually dissipated after causing severe damage in Mason, Ohio, in Warren County, north of Cincinnati. Louisville, Kentucky was hit by an EF4 tornado, which demolished most of the Kentucky Fair and Exposition Center and then traveled more than 20 miles through Louisville's suburban areas, totally destroying more than 900 homes and damaging thousands more. Another EF5 tornado formed in Indiana and tracked about 60 miles or so across rural country, lessening the destruction it wrought to buildings but creating havoc with power lines and vehicles. One vehicle thrown by the storm was an empty school bus, which the tornado deposited in a ditch where it crushed and killed a woman attempting to shelter there. She is one of 6 fatalities in that storm. Tanner, Alabama, was hit by the 2 separate tornadoes, the second coming as rescue efforts were underway to assist people trapped by destroyed buildings from the first. Both were EF5 tornadoes. The first caused 28 fatalities and leveled most of the small community. The second finished the job. In the super outbreak of 2011, Tanner was hit again by yet another EF5 tornado. Alabama is not generally considered part of Tornado Alley, though evidently tornadoes don't care for such distinctions. According to a paper published by NOAA and Northern Illinois University in 2000, about 10% of the tornadoes reported in the United States are significant. For the purposes of their paper, significant is defined as any EF2 or greater tornado. According to their analysis of the data presented and discussed in the paper, the authors note, "The primary area of the U.S. in which significant tornadoes occur most often is in an L-shaped region from Iowa to Oklahoma to Mississippi, with the highest threat in Oklahoma." The paper also notes in its discussion paragraphs, "Developments and enforcement of building codes designed to enhance tornado survival could be useful in high-risk regions." The paper describes the L-shaped area as Tornado Alley, and it largely agrees with the area so designated by the Air Force meteorologists who coined the term in 1952. Oklahoma, along with Kansas and Texas, has long been held in the public mind as a center of tornado activity. Yet, according to other sources and analysis, the long-held image of what comprises Tornado Alley may be accurate. Of the 10 deadliest tornadoes in American history, that is, as measured by the cost of human life, Oklahoma appears in just one, the 1947 Woodward tornado, which killed 181 people and injured nearly 1,000. That tornado was spawned by a thunderstorm that formed over Texas, moved north at over 50 miles per hour, and caused over 60 fatalities in Texas before crossing into Oklahoma. It hit Woodward as an EF5 tornado, leveled over 100 city blocks, and killed 116 people in the city. As of October 2022, it remains the deadliest tornado ever to strike in Oklahoma. Since the development of tornado forecasting, monitoring of weather conditions, improved radar, and early warning systems have improved safety when tornadoes threaten. Forewarned people can, for the most part, take steps to protect themselves when severe weather threatens. People can move, but buildings can't. Destruction from tornadoes continues both within the traditional region known as Tornado Alley and in the areas outside its imaginary boundaries. In 1995, there were 1,245 tornadoes reported in the United States, with 419 of them, less than half, coming in accepted Tornado Alley states. In 2005, 327 of the nation's 1,264 reported tornadoes occurred in Tornado Alley. A decade later, 529 in Tornado Alley contributed to 1,193 nationwide. With the exception of 2004, when Nebraska led the nation in tornado-related injuries, Texas, Oklahoma, or Kansas has claimed that distinction every year since 1995. So there is still evidence of Tornado Alley's propensity to create violent storms, which literally roll over anything in their way. But there's also evidence that Tornado Alley, at least in terms of its undefined borders, has shifted to the east across the Mississippi River, with its western boundaries moving along with the rest of the imaginary region. According to a 2018 study published by Dr. Victor Gensini, a professor of meteorology at Northern Illinois University, not only is the frequency of tornadoes trending downward in Tornado Alley, it is at the same time increasing east of the region. Referring to Texas and Oklahoma, Gensini wrote, "They're still the number one location in terms of tornado frequency, but the trend in many locations is down over the past 40 years." Gensini also noted, "We've shown the tornado frequency trend is increasing in the Midwest and Southeast." The study also observed that tornado-caused deaths had risen over the same time period in the Southeast, citing factors such as longer and larger tornado paths, expanding population density, mobile home density, and higher nighttime tornado probabilities. The role of climate change is also mentioned. Clearly, there is a climate change signal here. What's causing the change is still an open question. Climate change further dries the already dry air of the Southwest, and that air mass moves steadily eastward into the area known as Tornado Alley. The dry air contacts the moist air from the east and north in a place known as the dry line, where severe weather is born. Additionally, researchers at Columbia University have issued findings which indicate the climatic line between the humid east and the arid west, long marked by the 100th meridian of longitude, is gradually shifting eastward. In other words, the dry air of the western plains is replacing the receding humid air of the east. The conditions that existed when the U.S. Air Force meteorologists first identified and named Tornado Alley in 1952 have changed, but their interactions with each other leading to the formation of tornadoes have not. What they named Tornado Alley still exists, though indications are that it has moved and will continue to move for the foreseeable future. Overall, according to the National Weather Service, the average number of tornadoes in the United States has remained more or less consistent since the 1950s. Some increases over the past six decades have occurred not because there are more tornadoes, but because of better and expanded monitoring of weather conditions. The same is true in Canada, where large expanses of unpopulated land have come under better observation. If the number of tornadoes has remained constant overall, but increased in the eastern portions of the country, it stands to reason the number of tornadoes in Tornado Alley has decreased. Data collection and analysis bears this out. Tornado Alley is still the leader in producing twisters, but the road to parity with more eastern regions has been traveled for years. When and if parity is achieved is anybody's guess. There's increasing evidence that though the number of annual storms remains constant, the number of violent storms, that is, those above EF2, is increasing. A 1999 tornado in Oklahoma, the heart of Tornado Valley, reached wind speeds of 320 miles per hour, the highest wind speeds ever recorded anywhere on Earth. Among the many fatalities, it destroyed buildings and equipment on the Tinker Air Force Base, where tornado forecasting was born over 50 years earlier. It was the first tornado to cause over $1 billion in damages and the deadliest in Oklahoma since the Woodward tornado in 1947. 36 people died as a direct result of the storm. Whether nature's most violent storms are becoming even more violent as a result of climate change remains, like climate change itself, a matter of debate for some. Probably not, though, for those who have just endured their mindless and unavoidable destruction. For unavoidable, they are. Tornadoes can occur in any one of the United States with little warning, particularly during those times of the year when weather is changeable due to seasonal trends. They are most prevalent during the spring and summer, and for the time being, in that ill-defined but well-known section of the country known as Tornado Alley, followed by Dixie Alley. Vigilance and caution are the watchwords during weather events likely to spawn tornadoes, whether in Oklahoma or Alabama, Kansas or Virginia, or anywhere else on the North American continent.